Two people are dead after a small jet crashed near Indianapolis Regional Airport in Hancock County.
Investigators with the NTSB are on scene working to figure out how this happened. WISH TV's Jenny Draisler was there all afternoon. And Jenny, what have you learned today?
Well, I can tell you there's a lot more questions than answers right now, Mike and Kylie. But what I can tell you is once the NTSB investigation is wrapped up here in the next few hours, we will likely get more information as to what went wrong inside that airplane and how these two people died.
Anytime you're dealing with a plane crash, you expect the worst, and this one is.
Smoke could be seen for blocks billowing from this airplane that crashed Wednesday afternoon near Indianapolis Regional Airport.
It's a fatal crash, which is tragic.
Sergeant John Perrine with Indiana State Police says it all happened around 12:45 Wednesday afternoon when Hancock County Sheriff's officials got calls from people driving by who said they saw an airplane crash in a field about a half mile northeast of the airport. Indiana State Police say the small Cessna Citation jet was taking off from the airport when it crashed. A Cessna Citation is Cessna's corporate business line of jets and typically seats about 12 people. Investigators confirmed only two people were on board the plane at the time of the crash. Police say because of where the plane crashed, in a rural cornfield, first responders had a hard time actually getting to it.
The scene also prevented some problems as the muddy field, you know, probably a quarter to a half a mile off of the road here. And so we're fortunate that we have partners here in Hancock County that were able to provide some utility vehicles, four-wheel drive vehicles to get the firefighters to the scene.
State police say they have identified the two victims, but they won't release that information until the family has been notified. At this point in time, we do not know for sure where the plane came from or where it was headed. Once we get information from the NTSB's investigation, we'll be sure to update you on air and online at wishtv.com. Jenny Draisler, WishTV News 8.